Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston Station, we are ready for this event.
Houston ACR, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is Houston ACR. How do you hear me?
Loud and clear. Happy to do this event with you.
Please stand by for opening remarks.
Hello, I'm Stefan Koss, a STEM special education teacher here at the Computer School in New York City. Throughout my teaching practice, I've always believed that curiosity is everything. But here's what I've learned. Curiosity alone isn't enough. It's when we come together that real magic happens. Students asking questions, astronauts sharing their experiences from 250 miles above us, that's when exploration becomes extraordinary. Thank you for coming, and now for our first question.
Hi, my name is Lucas, and my question is, why is space exploration important to you?
That's a great question. Thank you for asking. I personally think humankind always needs like a frontier in order to live happily. So that's why we keep doing explorations.
And I agree with Kimi-san. I think exploring that frontier is so important to inspiring the next generation.
Hi, my name is Zoe, and my question is, if you had the choice, would you rather live in space or on Earth based on your experiences?
Hi, Ellie. I have a lot of fun up here in space. Kimi-san and I, we're great friends. We enjoy the views of Earth together, sharing stories over dinner, and the work we do is very rewarding. But Earth is still my favorite place to be. It's my home, and it's where everyone I love is still there. And so, of course, for me, I'd rather live on Earth.
Hi, my name is Matthew. My question is, how do astronauts sleep in space?
Yeah, good question. Actually, sleeping in space is great without gravity. How long we can sleep, we don't have any like back pain or anything. We have a very interesting research, wear some like a special equipment and compare with the quality of the sleep on Earth and also on orbit.
Hi, my name is Yusuf, and my question is, what type of training did you have to do before going to space?
So I was selected in 2017, and when I first arrived, there was a couple years of training, learning ISS systems, a lot of the engineering components and how that works, also learning Russian, learning to work together in a team. All of that comes together, especially before a space flight, to prepare for all the varied missions that we have to do, including spacewalks. So the training is very, very diverse. We all come from diverse backgrounds, and with that teamwork, and a lot of support from ground, we're able to have a really successful mission.
Hi, my name is Henry, and my question is, what are some of the emergency procedures you have in space? Do you prepare for all the situations that could happen up there? Does debris ever fly into the space station?
That's a very good question, Harrison. And actually, we have emergency procedures. We are preparing any kind of situations. For example, like a fire in ISS, or like a air leak from space station, or like ammonia leak into the space station. We have prepared everything. And fortunately, we didn't have any like experience that debris came through to the ISS. But in case that in such kind of bad case, we are prepared for anything. So because of the good training, yeah. We are prepared for that. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Scarlett. And my question is, how do you move forward while floating?
Hi, Scarlett. We can move forward, backwards, up, down, even somersaults. And I'm going to do my best to show you. But we essentially just push off with our feet or our hands. And I'm going to show a little demonstration of kind of going forward. And all I did there was kind of use my feet to push myself. And because there's microgravity here, once we have a force enacted upon us and we're moving in a direction, until we stop ourselves by touching something, we're going to keep going in that direction, just like I am right now.
Hi, my name's Ellie, and my question is, what do you guys do for entertainment in space?
That's a very good question. We have a lot of things actually to entertain us. Yeah, for example, eating dinner with crew members, or maybe we did some like space embedded sport last time. And also we can watch movies together. So we have a lot of things to entertain us. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Connor. And my question is, what's the most surprising thing you've had to adapt to living in microgravity that you didn't anticipate before you got there?
Ooh, there are a lot of things to adapt to. I think the most surprising thing is how easy it is to lose something. You know, on Earth, if I set something down on the coffee table or anywhere, I could turn around and it'll be there. But in space, if I set something down or maybe it comes off of Velcro, I could turn around and then when I turn back, it could be completely missing. So in space, you have to be really thoughtful and intentional of where you place things, even temporarily.
Hi, my name is Logan. My question is, what's the next experiment you would like to do in space?
That's a great question, Logan-san. I'm really looking forward to release a small satellite from Kibo module. We are using this kind of airlock. So we are going to do this soon, so I'm pretty interested in and looking forward to do it. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Daniela, and my question for you is, when you were little and look up at the stars, would you ever think that you would be up there in space?
Hi, Daniela. The answer is no. I never really thought I would ever be an astronaut as a kid. Sure, I had dreams looking up in the stars, but I never thought that it would be possible. And I think it's a reflection of how we are all here today from different countries and backgrounds that oftentimes in life, our path is not a straight line. And we're going to have challenges and bumps along the way. But I think as long as you work hard and you're a good human being and you're very nice, you can get really, 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 really far, and sometimes you'll end up in the stars.
Hi, my name is Trixie, and my question is, how do astronauts filter out air in the space station? Since there's no air in space, how do they get rid of used air like carbon dioxide?
Okay, thank you. Very good question. Actually, we have very good equipment. So filter like a carbon dioxide, which we are producing. And also, we use like water to produce oxygen. And if we produce oxygen from water, we have like hydrogen. And we use hydrogen and also carbon dioxide to actually reproduce water. So we can circulate in this kind of system and very ecosystem. Yep. Thank you.
Hi, my name is David, and my question is, how do you get electricity in space?
So we have these massive solar arrays, 8 of them actually, outside of the space station. If we were to open these windows, we might actually be able to see some of them. And so these massive solar arrays, they capture all of the sun's rays, the photons, and it converts that into electricity, which we store in batteries when we're not in the sun's view.
Hi, my name is Eliza, and my question for you is, what are you guys looking forward to doing back on Earth?
Oh, that's a very good question, Heather-san. Yes, I really love ice cream, so I try to eat ice cream a lot when I go back to home. And also, of course, looking forward to see my family members. Thank you.
Hi. I'm Campbell, and I wanted to know that if we were to ever discover a habitable planet, would we have the resources to get there?
Hi, Campbell. So right now, we still have a lot to learn about how to live in space, how to get from far places from point A to point B. But that's also why the space station exists right now. We have had a continued presence, humans, in space for almost 25 years. That's pretty incredible. And we've learned so much of how to sustain ourselves, how to grow our own foods, and how to take care of ourselves in this harsh environment. And with all of that working together, I certainly believe there will be a future where we are able to get ourselves to a habitable planet.
Hi, my name is Guy. And my question is, how do you guys go through different time zones?
Oh, that's a very good question as well. Yes, we are using universal standard time, so winter time in London. So right now, 1:30 p.m. right now. Yes, thank you.
Hello, my name is Maddox. My question is, what would happen if someone were to get set on the International Space Station?
Hi, Maddox. So we try and keep things very, very clean. We try and keep ourselves in good shape. We exercise, we sleep, and we have flight surgeons who are physicians that are on call 24/7 to monitor our health and our well-beings. It is possible, though, and of course, we have a lot of training, we have medical supplies, and we also have a crew medical specialist on board that's ready at any given time to take care of any of us if any of us were to get sick.
Hello, my name is Harrison. My question is, what do you do if you run out of food?
Oh, that's a very good question. I don't think we have plenty of food actually right now. So we don't think that's going to happen because we have a lot of cargo vehicles coming. 2 weeks ago, we had Dragon. And soon we are going to have Cygnus and also HTVX from Japan. So I think we never run out of food. If it's really happened, probably we need to go back, but probably it wouldn't happen. Yeah, thank you.
Hi, my name is Nicholas, and my question is, will we ever go back to the moon? And if so, when?
Nicholas, yes, we are. And Artemis 2 is going to launch 4 astronauts no later than April of 2026. That's less than 1 year away. And so pretty soon we're going to have 4 astronauts who are going to have a spectacular view of Moon and Earth to share that with us.
Hi, my name is Robert, and my question is, how does it feel when you get back to Earth after being in space?
Oh, that's a very good question. 10 years ago, I came here and went back to Earth. I mean, Earth was a great place. That's actually our home, right? Yeah. Even if when I went back, it was minus 15 degrees Celsius or something like that, very cold. But I felt very comfortable. So Earth is a very nice place to live for everybody. So we need to protect this kind of environment. This is pretty precious place.
Hi, welcome, and thanks for joining us today. And a giant thank you to NASA for exposing the computer school and kids across the country to this wonderful opportunity. Keep soaring.
You're very welcome. Thank you for all of your attention and time, and kids and everyone watching. You are our inspiration. You are a reason for having a space station. And so keep learning as much as you can, continue to be kind to each other, and there's no limit to what you can achieve. Signing off from the International Space Station.
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event.
Thank you to all participants. Station, we are now resuming operational audio communications.